بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم رب زدني علما.
Okay, so the next thing we'll try to get into more details about the SDN controllers and the different forms, like it comes in physical or some kind of software. And then we'll also see some list of vendors offering the SDN controllers here. So we already discussed the SDN controller is like a brain of your network. So this SDN controller will be having some kind of software. Probably we call it as management software or some kind of software. With the help of this software, we can control or we can decide the forwarding decisions of your networking devices. So probably the networking devices, whether routers or switches, they will interact with the SDN controller through this software. And then this SDN controller can actually send some kind of instructions or maybe some kind of scripts or maybe some kind of specific commands to change the security policy or change the quality of service policy as per the application requirements. Okay, so the SDN controller will be running a software to control the devices, and with SDN, you'll be controlling everything from the controller, which is going to be a centralized console, and you don't need to actually touch any of the single devices. Means whether you are adding any new device, you can do automatically you can provision that device to come up. Like we discussed plenty of things in the previous topic with the network automation, like what can be automated in the previous topics. So let's try to see the different SDN controllers. Now the SDN software comes in two different forms. Now the first form is you can get something called a physical chassis or the physical appliance. Now, physical appliance is just like a dedicated appliance or the device, let's say a box, where normally the vendor sells the box or appliance. Now, you're going to fix this in the rack, and then you're going to provide the connectivity. And then this particular box comes with the software, the pre-installed SDN software inside it. Okay, so this is the common way of doing the SDN controller in general. Or you can also have your software installed on the server, where you can have your own dedicated server, and you can get a software in a form where some vendors offer in the form of software, where you can install this software install or running on your own server, or you can also run in a cloud, because most of the applications nowadays hosted on the cloud. Like we have something called Amazon Cloud or Microsoft Cloud or even Cisco Cloud, and that particular cloud is nothing but a network where you are hosting your applications, and that is going to connect to your network, and you are going to run these applications here or the software here on the cloud or on the remote servers, and from there you are going to control your network via SDN controllers. So the common option, now different vendors offer in different forms. Like we have multiple vendors offering these SDN controllers here. Like specifically, if you talk about Cisco, Cisco offers the SDN controllers in the form of something called appliance. We have something called Cisco Epic Appliance. Now this Epic stands for Application Policy Infrastructure Controller. Now this is a dedicated appliance where you can run the SDN software. So if you are going with Epic controller, you may have a pre-installed SDN controller software. Okay. Now we do have something called Cisco ACI. So let's first see about Cisco. Cisco ACI. ACI is again software application centric infrastructure. That's what it stands for. Now Cisco entered into this SDN market by acquiring a company, something like INSEM, probably in 2013, and started with a product called Cisco ACI. Now Cisco ACI again is a new fabric based data center architecture automation. So most of the data center automation is done with the help of a software or called as ACI, which is referred as again application-centric infrastructure. Now this ACI generally runs in multiple hardwares. You can run this on an EPIC controller, so, or even this also runs in Cisco 9000 series switches. Okay, so again, this API, there are different models in this API. EPIC, we have something like M3 and L3 models, which is like medium for medium configurations or maybe for large configurations. And also this can also can be a part of a virtual appliance. So even it can, this EPIC comes in a virtual appliance where you can run on your own server as well. Now, there is something called EPIC EM. EPIC EM is for enterprise network, for enterprise management. Now, this is again end of sale. I think somewhere around mostly in 31st January 2020. Now, Cisco has stopped this EPIC EM product for enterprise management. Now, you have a dedicated Cisco EPIC model, and then there is M3, L3, based on the size of your network or size or the requirement in general. Okay, so we'll be running something called Cisco EPIC product, which runs some kind of data center management software like ACI or Cisco DNM. Probably we'll talk about DNA a little bit more in detail later on for the enterprise management with EPIC. Now, when you talk about other vendors like, apart from Cisco EPIC, we have something called VMware NSX. Now, this VMware comes into picture for SDN probably in 2012 where it has acquired something called a different company, like I think there is something called NICIRA. So acquire this company and get into the SDN market. Now this NSX is going to provide a full range of networking capabilities in the form of virtualized network farm. Apart from that, again, you have something called Nokia New Age Networks. Now Nokia is one of the leader in the telecom. Mainly it focuses on offering the service provider virtualized network platform. Virtualized service provider platform, we can say. And mainly it offers you the products to optimize your data center or the cloud or and the SDN operations. Again, we have something like Juniper. Juniper entered into the SDN market probably in 2013 after acquiring a company called Contrail Systems in 2002. It has acquired. And now the product from Juniper, we call it as Juniper Contrail. And also there are some other vendors like Big Switch Networks. Now this Big Switch Networks is mainly a US-based cloud and data center networking company, which was founded in 2010. So this Big Switch have different products like Cloud Fabric. There is something called Big Switch Cloud Fabric, and there is something called Switchlight software it offers. And these, with the help of these tools, it is going to offer you something called SDN solution. So it offers you the SDN solution or open flow SDN solution for private, public, and the hybrid cloud environments.